we're in for.
Who's for you? I'm not a cheer clap.
She hasn't done a cheer clap.
Cheer.
They're fine. It's honestly fun. They're fun. It's just, it's a little different. Betsy and them, they were gonna stay.
Oh, were they?
But they thought it was like gonna be like Wednesday's class. And I was like, yeah, no.
No.
No. It's not like Wednesday's class.
Oh, no. Oh, and by the way, Mom is gonna come tomorrow. She wanted me to tell you because
okay,
we're
good.
Taking her dog over to get a groom. It's a, he had that seizure the last time.
Yeah.
Now she's, we're going to try again. Hopefully, no, she's been on medication. She said you usually set up with chairs. Like,
I do.
Will you
jump
down?
No, Mom so will miss her.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know what? It was so cute last week whenever Carol came in and Cass and Shirley were both like, we miss you. And your mom was like, it's nice to be missed.
Yeah.
And I was like,
you know, we love watching her. Because you know, as people get older, a lot of times they think that nobody notices them. Right. That's not true.
Yeah.
You know?
Mom's finding that, I mean, they've been in Seminole, you know, they've been here for 2 years, or
yeah.
2 years, whatever.
Like, they've known of Mom and Dad, but they only went to, like, 2 things the whole time before Dad passed away, not until recently. So, now she's starting to get out, she goes on Thursdays to Bunko, you know, Bunko, whatever they call it. I'm taking her to the pool, and it just happens to be like the same time they're getting done water aerobics, and we're all like hanging out. I took her up there yesterday, like, Shirley, come join us! Of course, we had been in the pool for like 30 minutes already. And she's like, and I drove the golf cart, and she wasn't like all there yesterday. She's like, maybe next time. And then they're just starting to like strike it out. She's with her now, and she's. Really started.
Good.
So, yeah, they invited her. Oh, you have to come put dominoes and this. I'm like, I'm not driving your happy ass here, so you better start.
Get a friend.
I'm like, you need to start driving that golf cart.
Girls. So one of those. So that exercise, whenever I have them come out of the chair, that's one of her PT exercises. Is that my understanding?
Yes. So and. If she can't get up that way, her PT guy said for her to cross her arms and then do it.
Try to
somehow
up.
Balances
yeah.
her. So that's why you'll see.
She
tries the way you do it,
yep.
But then she'll only try it so many times.
Right.
And then she just crosses her arms and she's doing really good. She was a little. She even walked the driveway today without her cane. I had it in my hand.
Wow.
But she forgets that she can only concentrate on one thing at a time when she's walking or doing something.
Right.
That sounds like Mom.
Yeah.
That's what I would tell her.
We're in the house today.
Do not talk and walk.
Well, we're in the house today. She's just like all of a sudden, and I'm like, yeah. And she starts wobbling, and it's just like she'll be down.
Right.
Nothing. Flat. She did that outside with the. There's a little crack on the sidewalk, and she went to turn around and look at her flowers in the memory garden. And she started, and I'm like,
ah, what are you doing?
Yeah, right?
And I'm constantly, I feel like her mother is like, cut it out!
Mom's like, sometimes you're not my mother. I'm like, well, somebody's
gotta
watch out.
Start acting like my mother!
Somebody's gotta watch out for
I'm
you.
Like, she's good. I mean, she knows that when I yell at her, it's...
You're just not told.
She knows that if I'm yelling at her, it's because she deserves it.
Yeah. Mom gets that too.
I'm like, I don't need to be a bitch, Mom, but... She's like, oh, I know. Sorry, she says to me, they posted, they need a treasurer for Seminole Cove. I said, don't even think about it. You can't get your own shit done. Like, you really need more. I said, next year, maybe you can be more involved with the code, with the board. I'm like, no. Let's, but I did, she's going to Texas. Woo! I'm gonna have 10 days, other except for going to give the cat insulin.
There you go.
But we made the reservations, she'll be gone.
Half. Oh,
yeah, I'm a little nervous about it, but
yeah.
Not about her being gone. My aunt will
will be fine.
It's...
Yes?
It's the whole getting her from the airport, like, right, when we get there. I've already got her signed up for wheelchair assistance, because that's just way too much walking.
Absolutely.
She'll be down, and I'll get a phone call before she even gets on the plane.
Yeah, it's
just
a lot safer.
So I have her all set up with wheelchair assistance, but just the whole thought about it, like, okay, let's think about this. I said, Mom, you're gonna have to go all the way to the back of the plane. I said, so she's closest to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Like, she has to make sure she goes every hour, otherwise. So when I pack her on board thing, it's X amount of, you know, depends. Right. Make sure she has extra clothing and. And then I'll pack a bag, like in a plastic bag, and say, okay, this is what you're going to come home on the plane with, so that same thing backwards. And then is someone going to stay with her in on her layovers?
I actually talked everybody I know into having an oh shit bag in their car. It's like a little plastic bag with like an extra change of underwear and pants and like baby wipes and toilet paper, just in case you're somewhere and something happens or you end up, you know.
I mean, she's a lot better since her surgery.
Yeah.
But still.
Why is this? I mean, I've had moments coming back from like Yeehaw and like, you know, and being like, I'm going to shit myself. Like, I don't know what I'm going to do.
You can be like my dad and open your door and shit all in the door.
He told me that story. It's like, what did you do?
You did what?
You did what?
Oh,
that's funny right there.
He's like, well.
Yes, when you gotta go, you gotta go.
That's good shit right there. And with that, I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So I will say that all of your chairs have been tested. I've jumped on them, so if they creak and stuff a little bit. I jumped on them, to make sure that they were safe.
Look at her feet.
Yeah, like to make sure they're all safe, so even though they sound creaky. Even though they sound creaky, they will support you. So we'll just come to a nice, comfortable seat. Now let's sit back in the chair. Palms can be face up, face down. Roll the shoulders back. Close the eyes. Much like when we normally start class, just going to bring our attention into our breath and our body. Let everything else about the day just take a back seat for a moment. Just taking a nice cool breath in through your nose and out. And out in a nice, smooth, even manner. Maybe we'll get lucky and have some rain for Shavasana.
I can't.
I'm great.
I heard
it's like
make a noise.
My one hand doesn't. It's the arthritis
in
my fingers.
It's
I just
never,
can't do it.
We're going to work on snapping now. Toes lifting and snapping, that's right. So next feet, yeah, go. So go ahead and give the toes and fingers a little wiggle. Keeping the eyes closed, go ahead and turn the head to the right. Drop the chin down just a little bit. Pick it back up, bring it back to center. And then to the left, same thing, dropping the chin down ever so slightly towards the shoulder. Back up, bringing it back to center. And then we'll take the chin down to the chest. Lift back up. And then if it feels okay, you can let the head drop back a little bit, opening up the throat. And then go ahead and roll your head to the right, forward, to the left, taking a full neck rotation if that feels okay. Or if not, just go from side to center to the other side. You can go in both directions as fast or as slow as you'd like. Come back to center. Go ahead and open up the eyes. We'll come off the back of the chair to come forward a little bit more. Like almost where your butt is like basically the only thing left on the chair. Your feet are in front of you. You can have your feet together or apart, that's up to you. We'll bring the hands to the thighs. We'll go ahead and puff the heart forward, look up towards the ceiling, drop the head back, take a breath in. And then exhale, round the spine. Okay. Tuck the chin, tuck the tummy. Tuck the chin, tuck the head. mouth and the heart forward, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, round, sit back a little bit. Nice. We're going to go two more like that. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Now stay in this exhale state and just swivel through the shoulder blades a little bit, kind of going side to side. And then go ahead and come back to a center position. Feet are flat on the floor. Go ahead and take your hands forward. Thumbs are going to point up towards the ceiling. You're going to reach the arms up overhead. And then we're going to open them out to the side. Bring them back forward and up. Reach up. Let the shoulders come up into the ears. Open them back out. Forward and out. Nice. Forward and out. And one more. Shoulders around a little bit. You want to?
I can. I'm going to faint tomorrow afternoon.
I'm going to open up the shoulders a little bit.
This will be good before I paint.
Now I want you to go ahead and bend the elbows, bring the elbows in close to the body, make a little fist. We're going to bring the arms forward and then back like we're carrying something. We go forward, back, one more like that. And then come back to center, and we're going to open out, bring them back, kind of like our wings, open them out, bring them back, one more, bring them back. Nice. Now I want you to reach your arms forward and up, twist to your left, bring both hands down. One hand on the back of the chair, one hand on the outside of that knee. Use the chair to twist you a little bit more, maybe looking over the left shoulder. Be careful. Sometimes when you have a chair, you can crank yourself a little too far. Be mindful of that. Bring the left arm up alongside the ear, and then we'll reach over to the right. So think right shoulder going towards your right kneecap. We'll come back to center, left hand will come down, we'll rotate back to the middle. Nice, reach the arms out and up. Twist to the right this time, one hand on the back of the chair, one hand on the outside of that knee, and then using your breath to get you more into the twist. Remember, you can look over that right shoulder if you want. Don't have to. Your inhales will lengthen you up towards the ceiling. Your exhales may twist you a little bit more if you're not already at your full twist. Right arm's going to reach up alongside the ear, and then we're going to lean to the left. Reach a little bit further with that right hand, and then come up, bring the right hand down. Perfect. You're going to bring the hands underneath your right thigh. We'll bring the knee into the chest. Nice. Now I want you to hug that knee in towards your belly, and then bring your arms up into goalpost. Nice. Keep hugging it up. Flex your toes, and then extend the right leg out. Bring the knee in. Extend it out. Bring it in. Extend. Bring it in. Extend. Bring it in. Hold. And then cross that ankle over your left thigh. Bring the hands down, one hand on the knee, one hand on that bottom foot. Then we're going to roll this puppy around a little bit.
Oh, mom's cracking.
And since I love you guys so much, we're going to thread our fingers in here. Yeah, we're going to get up in there. Don't be afraid. If it's painful, it's supposed to be. Too much, but maybe you guys understand it, because I'm sure you guys all have significant others or men in your life maybe that you know. My boyfriend always has lint in his belly button. I'm like, what is this with men? Like, clean that stuff out. He's like, I clean it out every day. I was just like, how do you not feel that?
Oh my god.
How do you not use your washcloth and begin?
I mean, it's not that difficult.
Back home, I used to work at Sherwin-Williams for my father-in-law. We had a district manager, no word of lie. This guy would come in and he'd be like picking the lint out.
In public?
In public.
Absolutely not.
In the paint store.
Absolutely not. No. Right hand on the knee, left hand on the foot. Sit up nice and tall. Then I want you to lean towards your foot. There we go. Now, if you feel like this might be a little easy, take your hands in front of your shin and just let them dangle down towards the floor. There you go. Nice. Flex your right foot. Reach down a little bit more with the fingers, and then we'll come up, uncross the leg, set it down, we'll go to the other side. So hands are going to come underneath the left thigh, we're going to bring that knee into the chest, and then we're going to bring the arms into goalpost. Nice, now hug it up, extend the leg out,
Bring it in. Extend. Bring it in. Nice. Keep going. Three. Two. Now this last one, we're going to hold it in. Hold it in towards the belly and then cross that left ankle over your right thigh. Nice. Bring the hands down onto the foot. Thread your right fingers in between the toes. And then if it's too painful, just hold there with the fingers in. If you want to add more, you can kind of go back and forth with the toes and roll them around a little bit. You can also massage the bottom of the foot too. You can kind of do double duty on there, especially if you're on your feet all day. Right.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Oh, you're already coughing. Okay.
She's awfully quiet today. She must be tired.
She is tired. I know she only got like, what, 3-4 hours of sleep last night?
True.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. Oh my, and then worked all day and then taught Zumba and now she's sitting here in yoga.
Okay. I'm indestructible.
You are indestructible. For sure. Hand on the foot, other hand on the knee, sit up nice and tall, and then lean towards that shin. Nice. When you feel that stop there, or if you feel like you can bring the hands in front of the thigh or in front of the shin, you can do that. Uncross the leg. Perfect. Take your feet out wide. Toes kind of pointed out at an angle. We're going to bring the right forearm onto the right thigh. We're going to bring the left arm up towards the ceiling. So this is the first step. The second step, we're going to take our fingertips on the inside of that right ankle towards the floor. Left arm's reaching up. You can look up at the hand if that feels okay, or you can stay looking down at the floor. But using your arm on this right leg, twist, open up through the chest a little bit more. Maybe take that left hand back a smidge, and then I want you to release the head. Left arm's gonna come down to the ground. We're gonna come into a forward fold with our hands on the floor. We release the head, give it a little shake out. And then left hand on the inside of that left ankle, reach the right arm up towards the ceiling. Again, if you've ever got shoulder jazz and you don't like the idea of lifting that arm, you can just keep it on the hip. You don't have to reach it up towards the ceiling. Open up a little bit more with that right hand, leaning into that left leg. And then right hand's going to come down. All right, so we're going to bring one hand on top of the thigh, the other hand on top of the thigh will come up. Perfect. Bring the feet together. Extend your right foot out in front of you. Left foot is bent still, or left knee. Take your right hand down towards your toes. And then if you've got your foot, you can kind of pull back a little bit on your toes. See how that feels for the calf. And release. We'll switch sides. Right foot down, left foot forward. Flexing the toes towards the face and then gliding that left hand down, reaching towards the toes. Nice. And then pull back on those big toes. Because you have multiple on your left side, did you know? Sometimes when stuff comes out, I'm like, brain. You jumbled there. A little mixed up. Huh?
Good.
We'll come back up, bring the left foot back down. Nice. Take your feet out a little bit. We're going to come up off the chair. All right? So, we're going to do it with no hands. Bring your hands out to the side, or you can have them behind the head or crossed over, whatever you'd like to do. We're going to lean forward, come up, and stand up. Nice. Now bring your hands to your hips. We're gonna come down nice and slow, all the way back down onto the chair. Nice, come up, squeeze the butt, hug the butt, and then take the butt down, tap, come up, squeeze, there you go, tap, up, squeeze, tap, up, squeeze, tap, up, squeeze. If you need to adjust your feet a little bit, you can, tap. Lift it up, tap the butt, lift it up, one more, and then stay lifted, turn, place your blanket on the back of your chair, like just kind of drape it over the back, perfect, and then we're going to sit back down, come forward a little bit in the chair so you're not right on the back, lean back, bring your hands behind your head, and then we're going to go ahead and let the head drop back, kind of leaning the shoulder blades into the chair, a little back bend here. Come back up. And then lean back. Come back. Lean back. Ooh, hold there. Come back up. Come up. We're going to come all the way up off the chair. Nice. Now you're going to place your chair at the top of your mat with the seat facing you. And y'all can go ahead and just move the blanket off to the side for now. We'll just come back to that in a little bit. So we're going to stand a little bit from behind the chair. We're going to do little toe taps in there. So I have my feet a little bit more than hip distance apart. I'm going to bring my hands to the hips. And we're just going to tap the left toes in and tap them down, just the left side. Tap, down, tap, down. Now there's a couple of ways that you can do this. You can be coming straight at it, tapping and bringing it back down, or you can do a little out and around, tap and around. So if you feel like your hips might be a little tight, or maybe just going like this doesn't feel that great, you can always switch it up a little bit, come from the outside, and then tap.
Feels
better? Yeah. See, I have a lot of opening as far as external goes, so I try to kind of challenge myself a little bit more. But I know for a lot of people, if that's tight, that feels so much better. I'm gonna go for about three more taps. Ooh. Two, one. Now I want you to keep that foot into the chair. We're gonna bring the right hand into the seat of the chair. And then the left arm is going to go up towards the ceiling. Stretching out a little bit more through the chest, take that left arm back. And then we're going to bring that left hand down on the inside of the left leg. Kind of heel toe that left foot out to the very edge. And then we're going to extend this left leg back behind us. Ooh, there we go. So readjust yourself. I'm going to bring my hands right into this bottom part of the chair. I'm kind of holding on the edges, right? Back leg is extended, and my head is right over the seat of the chair. If you need to adjust yourself, move yourself forward or a little more away from it, feel free. Right knee is bent. We're going to bring this left knee in. We're going to bend it, bring it towards your nose, or around the spine a little bit, and then extend the left leg back out. Exhale, bring it in. Extend it back out. Bring it in. Extend. Bring it in. Extend. Last one. Now stay in that extended pose. Nice. Keep the left hand on the chair. Bring your right hand to your hip. Nice. There we go. Left foot's going to come in to meet the right foot. You're going to come up standing. Nice. Shake out the legs a little bit.
I'm just gonna be out.
That's good. I like it. Honestly. I can dig it. I can dig it. So we're gonna go to the other side with the toe taps. So hands are whatever you want. If you can just have them by your side, that's fine. If you want to have them in power stance, that's cool too. We'll bring this foot in, tap. And then tap. Excuse you. Tap. Bring it down. Tap. Bring it down. And again, you can go from the outside or the inside. Now check in with that standing leg every so often. If it's locked out, if it's feeling a little cranky, give it a little soft bend. Yeah, it's going to make it work a little bit more, but it might feel a little better. Whew. Three, two, and we're going to hold it in there. Bah. Nice. Left hand's going to come into the seat of the chair. Right hand on the thigh. We'll twist the torso to the right and then extend the right arm up towards the ceiling. Very nice. And you can adjust how close your foot and your hands are, right? Like they can be really close together, or one can be on one side and the other can be on the other side. And if this feels too tight, you can always place it on the back of the chair also. You're gonna bring this right hand down on the inside of the right leg. And then we're gonna extend the right leg back behind us into the air. Reposition your hands. So I always like to grab the bottom on the edges. Scooch my left leg back a little bit so my face is right above the seat of the chair. Right leg is extended and your head's lifted, so it's looking right down into your seat.
Then on the next exhale, we're going to bring the knee in towards the nose, round the spine. Inhale, extend. Exhale, knee towards the nose. If you can tap your knee to your right bicep, that's awesome. If not, that's awesome too. Extend, bring it in.
Okay, I got that.
Extend, there you go.
Me too.
Bring it in. Extend, bring it in. Nice, we're going for three more. Woo. Two more. Last one. Stay extended out. Right hand's gonna stay on the chair. Bring your left hand to your hip. Nice. Left hand's gonna come back down to the chair. Right foot's gonna come to meet the left, and then we'll come to standing.
Ah, she got the legs a little bit.
Good. Now, front facing the chair, I want you to bring your left foot right into the little section. I don't know what you would call this, the leg. The leg of the chair. And then I want you to lean over it.
Yeah. Aichi mamas.
Mm-hmm. You guys feel that stretch?
Yes. Holy cow. Yeah.
Which one is it? Sadist or masochist? Which one is she?
Sadist.
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 That's what I thought.
Yeah. Wait. Masochist likes to take pain, I'm pretty
sure.
We're
gonna start calling you Domino.
Come up. We'll switch the other side. But with love, you know, with love. So again, you don't have to do the full foot on the leg. And then kind of leaning into it. Yeah, if that's enough, stay there. If you want more, lean a little bit closer. And then you can also bend this left knee. And I feel like that, if you bring yourself closer to the back of the toe. You feel that, Lisa? Ooh. Ooh, okay. We're gonna come on out of that.
I didn't realize how like tight my calves were.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I
only have something to do with knee things.
Do you? Yeah, I do too.
And all the climbing up and down the ladders and
all that
climbing all over the counter.
But I least expected.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
at least Charlie horse.
Mm-hmm. You guys come to where you're standing beside your chair, beside the back of the chair. So we're going to hold onto the chair with the left hand. We're going to face towards the tree wall.
Give me a minute. Shit. I'm sorry. You guys will be with the right hand. Right hand.
Right here?
Right.
Out here?
Yep. Right behind
it. I'm like, wait, I'm so confused right now.
Okay.
It doesn't take much to
no.
know. Not when you have chairs involved. So right hand's on the chair or left. Bend your outside knee, and we're going to swing this bad boy back and forth.
Are you okay?
Yes. If you swing it back hard enough, I'll hit it with my hand.
I was like, I don't want to kick you in the face.
You are just fine, ma'am. I wish I had long legs.
You know what's really funny? Rack and I are going like the same.
Yeah, you are.
And you're like...
Oh, you caught up to us.
Alright, now, go ahead and release that leg. We're going to still hold on to the chair. I want you to bend your left knee up towards your chest. Extend it out in front of you and then swoop it back behind you and kind of lean so you're back in that same position we were just in. There we go. Bring the knee back in. Extend it out in front of you. Swoop it back. Nice. Bend the knee back in towards the chest. Extend the leg. Swoop it back. Nice. Come back up to standing. Left knee comes in. Extend. Swoop. And hold. Bring your left arm alongside your ear.
Just like a ballerina.
There you go. Soften the right knee a little bit. Push down into the foot. Reach with your left hand a little bit more. And then we're going to come back up to standing. Bring the left knee back in towards the chest. Set this left foot on the inside of the right leg. I don't care where. And bring your left arm up alongside the ear. Feel cool here, push down into the right leg, maybe bring the right hand to the hip. Maybe reach it up and for the other. When you're ready, come down, shake out that right leg, because I'm sure it's crying a little bit, and then we'll switch to go to the other side. Right hand on the hip, we're gonna swing the
right leg.
So you don't have to worry about it. I'm short.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure that I don't. It's always my biggest fear in yoga. Hit somebody with my hands or my feet.
Mine's hard. Honestly, mine was hard for a long time. And then I just realized something that happens. My biggest, it's like if I accidentally say something too juju, like, you know, like too new agey.
Too naughty. Well, that's what we're here for. I'll save you.
Chair. Square your toes so your left toe is pointing down towards the ground. And then we're going to do a twisted half moon. So left hand's going to stay on the chair. Turn your torso to the right and extend your right arm up. Woo. The left leg may go down a little bit. That's okay. Right hand's going to come back into the chair. We're going to bring this knee in. We're going to step it right into the seat. Come back up to standing. Bring the arms into goalpost, twist back to the left, hold there. Take your right hand to the outside of that left knee. There we go. Extend your left arm back behind you, twist a little bit more, maybe look back. Bring the left arm into a goalpost, right arm's gonna come back up into a goalpost, twist back towards your chair, interlace your hands behind your head. Soften your right knee a little bit. Roll the shoulders onto the back. Puff the heart up towards the ceiling. Lean the head back into the hands. Come back up. Bring the hands to the hips. Now, we're going to slide your left foot towards the front of your chair. Right? And then we're going to see if we can't pick it up and set it on the inside of the right thigh.
Ooh.
Maybe lift the arms up.
Ooh. That I can do.
Down.
Nice.
Look at all these trees today. Y'all are just so sturdy.
I can't do it with my hands on my hips.
You can have it up?
That's fine.
So if that works better, then you just have them all the way up already or out and then kind of go up. It's totally up to you. Girl. All right, right foot into the chair. Boom. Come into goalpost. Twist to the right. Perfect. Bring the left hand down into the chair, and then we're going to slide this right foot back into space, come into what's called half moon pose, or Ardha Chandrasana. You want to get funky with it. Ooh, shit. Right hand's going to come into the seat of the chair. Spin so your right toes are pointing down. Right hand's in the chair. Left arm's going to go up towards the ceiling. Woo! Very nice, guys. Very nice. Left hand's going to come back down into the chair. I'm going to bring this right knee in towards the nose. Step it into the chair. Come back up. Arms are going to come into goalpost. Twist to the right. Left hand to the outside of your right knee. Extend the right arm out, reaching back towards the back of the mat, maybe looking back at your right hand. Bring the right arm back into a goalpost. Left arm's going to come back into a goalpost. Twist yourself back to the front. And then slide the right toes onto the front of the chair. Maybe hold there. Maybe bring the right foot onto the inside of the left leg. Maybe reach the arms up. Bring the hands down. Lower yourself down. Nice! Very nice, guys. Alright. Hands are gonna come right into the seat of the chair. I'm gonna grab this top part, lift the head, and step your feet back. We're gonna come into a plank pose using the chair. So the shoulders are still pretty much over the wrist like they normally would be. You're on your toes. Bring your left knee in towards your chest. Here we go. Hold it there. And then small pulses up towards your left bicep. Trying to tap it. Tap, 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 tap. Step your left foot right in between the pegs of your chair. Nice. Stay on the back toes. We're going to lift up into a high lunge. Left knee stays bent. Arms come alongside the ears. Next, take the right heel down, turn the toe out, come for warrior two on the left side. Beautiful, right arm down the back leg, left arm will reach up and back. Come back into warrior two, hold here for a moment. Notice what your pelvis is doing, the butt, the ribs, trying to get everything nice and connected. Bring the left hand onto the seat of the chair. Right arm's gonna reach alongside the ear, palm faces towards the ground. So it's extended side angle with that left hand on the chair. Right hand's going to come down to the chair. We're going to twist so we're back onto the right toes. And then I want you to hop your right foot in a smidge. Take the heel to the ground. So your toe is facing at that 1 to 2 o'clock. Straighten your front leg. Okay, now here's the kicker. Think about your right hip. Right? Most of it is kind of open right now. What do you think about taking that right hip down towards the floor? I'm going to come around and then do a little scissor for you. At least to stay exactly where I'm going to go. This way. Yes.
Okay, well,
yes. Yes, 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 yes. But you still want to keep this in line long. So find like a more center. Drop back just a little bit. So, left knee is straight. Keep your right hand on the chair. Bring your left arm up towards the ceiling. This is called reverse triangle. Torso to the left, you can look up at the ceiling or stay looking down at the chair. Left hand's going to come back down. Beautiful. Slide your left foot back a little bit. Bend the knee. Transfer the weight into that front leg. Lift the back leg up. Whew. Here we go. And then small pulses up with this right leg. Keep going. Think about lifting with your butt instead of your legs. Really hard, a little muscle memory. You gotta think, butt lift, lift, squeeze the glutes. And then we're gonna step that right foot in to meet the left foot. Bend both knees, come into what's called chair pose. Ha ha, bring the arms up alongside the ears. Beautiful. Pull the ribs in so your tailbone tucks towards the floor. Feet are pushing down into the ground. You can look in between the hands or just look straight forward. Bring the hands by your sides, stand straight up. Ooh, nice, bring it to the other side. So, both hands on the back of the chair. Step both feet back for plank. And then this time, bring the right knee in towards the bicep. And then small pulses up towards that bicep. Kind of trying to tap it. If you can't, that's all right. Tap, 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 tap. Keep tapping. Whew. Three, two, One, two, three, four, five. Step the right foot in between the pegs of the chair. Nice. And we're going to come up into high lunge on the right knee. Take the left heel down, turn the toe out. We'll come into warrior two on this side. Nice. So the knee is still going towards the chair. If you feel like it's kind of caving in towards that peg leg, think about it going out and towards the chair. Back hand down the back leg. Right arm's going to reach up and back. Come back, warrior two. And then right palm on the chair. Left arm alongside the ear. Palm faces towards the floor. Left hand's going to come down into the chair. We're going to twist so you're back on those left toes. Scoot your back foot in a little bit. Take the heel to the floor. And then straighten the front leg. And then same thing as before. Kind of open up this left hip out to the side. And then see if you can't square it down towards the ground. If that feels okay, maybe bring the forearms into the chair.
Ooh, yeah,
that adds to it, yeah? Oh. Bring both hands back into the seat of the chair. Slide the right foot back a little bit. Transfer the weight to the right foot. Lift the left leg up.
Ooh.
And then small pulses with this left foot up towards the ceiling. Left foot's going to come in to meet the right foot, come up to standing, and then look up here. Nice. We're not going to give you a break today.
Alright?
You don't have to demo for me.
Oh,
unless you want to. If you want to, that's fine. I know you're tired, so I don't want to tucker you out even more. I think you can hold this.
Good word.
Tucker. Okay. So you might be wondering why I've done so much like split leg type work. That's because of what we're about to do, because your legs are going to be split when we come up into this downward dog using the chair. So it's totally up to you if you want to lift a leg up or you keep both feet planted firmly into the seat of the chair. I will ask you to come in.
Hold it.
Stand on the back of it. To make sure I don't go anywhere. So I'm going to come into a downward dog. I'm going to have my feet on the edges of my chair. So instead of them being like here, they're gonna be out to the side. So I'm gonna fold over and come into a downward dog, right? So we're here. We're gonna bring one foot into the chair, not all the way back here, more towards the front, and then we're gonna try to get the other one up. Okay? Now this might be a lot for you. You just stay just like this, right? Or maybe walk the hands in a little bit. Maybe lift the leg up. Now I want to mention, notice where my hands are to my shoulders. Okay, the closer they are underneath you, the more scary you might be, but the better it's gonna feel for your shoulders. So the more I walk my hands in, maybe lifting a leg up, maybe starting to play with this left foot. And then when I'm ready to come down, I come out to the side. Don't have to do this. You're like, today is not my day for it. That's fine. If you'd like to try it, I would stand, gladly stand behind some chairs.
Okay. Lisa goes first.
Feet in the chair first. There you go.
Oh, my feet slide well.
Yeah, they are. Now walk your hands a little closer. Perfect.
Yay!
Okay. Lisa, hold on a second. We're doing one at a time. Yep,
because
we've got to hold the chair.
Trying to
yell
at
Lisa.
I know, right? Look at that! This is actually how tall you are.
And you looked like so confident in this at this right? moment. Like compared to the first time you did this,
yeah,
like
it feels
good.
Does it?
Yes.
Yeah,
it's
right into
this.
When
you get used to it?
Yeah. Yeah. It doesn't feel scary. As scary.
Oh no!
You want to hold Natalie's chair?
You got this again. Second time's a charm.
What?
Second time's a
charm.
Nice. Alright, there you go.
Yeah. Does that feel okay? Yeah.
I'm walking right
in. Foot down. Bit. You feel okay to lift the other leg? Right.
There we go. Yeah! Yeah. Look at that.
Look at all these guys.
There
you
go, Jocelyn.
Yay!
Yeah.
I gotta
do more push-ups.
Woo! Very nice.
Good job.
Very nice. Alright, friend. Yeah. Come on, this is.
First time.
Hand set every day.
First time.
Your second time.
Oh.
You did it one more time.
I can't do it.
You got this.
Do you want to do
the doorway?
The doorway is too easy.
There you go, bro. Yes.
Yay. Oh, cramp. Again. Cramp. What?
I'm awake. Just kidding. Take a seat. Take a break.
Who else
wants to try it one more time? You see, you good? You good? Okay. You want to try it one more time?
Alright.
Go, Vanessa. Try to make
perfect.
Try to make stronger.
You want it on the edge?
Yeah, just fine. That helps you from slipping a little bit. Walk your hands closer to the chair. A little closer. Yeah, that ass over the shoulders.
Yay!
Very nice. Now lift your foot up and then push forward with this foot. So you're pushing. Yes.
Yes.
I'll
put both my paws on.
Oh, boy.
Yay.
Okay. I mean, you did so good. Like, I remember the first time you were so nervous.
Yeah, how long did I stay there?
I was so nervous.
Like a second? Yeah. But this time you got both legs up, you were good to go.
You want
to
do it again?
Got it!
There you go.
Nice!
Nice job!
Very nice. Very
yes!
Nice.
As long as one of us does it, we're good.
That feels weird though. It does, it kind of pushes your body off.
Oh, I'm terrified.
Aggressive.
splash dance with the water?
Yeah. Get one of our junk out and just...
Oh, we're done? We're done dancing already? Okay.
She was just warming up. She's getting like her third win.
I know, right?
She came to life. They said, dance.
I did!
I had a feeling. I was like,
I did.
You gotta turn that sand back on. Especially after that. Alright. Come to a seat. Roll the right shoulder around both directions. The other side. Hella funky.
Take your right hand down to the outside of your mat. Left arm's going to go up and over.
Those rules are
on top of the bottom knee, and then roll back to center. Nice. Keep it easy to the chest. Grab your strapola. Strapparella. Whatever you want to call her. Take the right foot into the strap. Make sure the foot up towards the ceiling. Left foot's going to go onto the ground. There we go. Keep the knee bent for right now. Hold onto the strap with the right hand. And then when you're ready, we're going to open it out to the right. Keep your left arm extended out to the side. If having it out in a T position is not your jazz, bend the elbow, palm face up. And then your choice if you want to look over the left shoulder, or you can just stay looking up at the ceiling. That is comfortable for you. Right? So laying on your belly is more comfortable. You're welcome to do that. Just take a few moments with your breath. Give yourself some time. Slightly longer than your inhales.
maybe some things that you weren't the biggest fan of, maybe some things that you didn't think you could do, but you did them. And then also reflecting on the thought process that you had during those moments, right? Like when you thought that you could do something and then you did it anyway, or if you were like, oh, I don't know how this is going to feel, and you might have enjoyed it or just had a different experience with maybe some of the poses that we do so often in class. And just remembering that even if your mind is like, oh, I don't think I can do that, you might actually be able to. And then figuring out how you can take that lesson and apply it to other things going on in your life, or maybe not something that's going on with you, but maybe something a friend or a family member is going through. You can give them a little bit of your strength. Bringing the hands to prayer in front of our hearts, bowing your chin to your chest, and giving yourself a huge thank you for making this time for yourself and for your practice. The divine light in me honors, bows, and recognizes the divine light in you.